Nothing says Christmas quite like insane, murderous snowmen. That's what we're painting up this week. Hey guys, what's going on? Michael here. So this week I've got some miniatures from Reaper Miniatures. We're going to be painting up some snowmen in honor of Christmas. But I can't just paint a snowman. No, I take it to a dark, dark place.
Do you wanna build a snowman?
Listen, just stay back! Just... Ow! 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 Ow!
Ow! Ow! That's your body! How are you?
World's most pissed off snow cone!
Welcome back, guys. So we're going to be starting off by cleaning up these miniatures a little bit. Now, they're pretty good. Reaper did a nice job with these casts, but there's a little bit of flashing around the arms and just a little bit on the bases. And I'll take a pair of side cutters and a file to get that a little smoother before we move on. After we clean them up, we're going to just use a little bit of super glue and zip kicker to glue these to their bases. With all the miniatures glued down, it's time to get to priming. Now, even though these snowmen are going to be mostly white, I'm going to base them out in black Vallejo primer. I like using black as an undercoat because I can thin out the white that'll go on in places to add little bits of shadow here and there if I so choose. With everything primed up, we're going to be using Vallejo's Arctic White, otherwise known as their white primer, but it's number 72.002 in their catalog. We'll use this to base out all of the snow areas, and we're going to also base out the candy cane in white. onto this candy cane. So we'll be using Vallejo's fresh blood to paint the stripes on the candy cane. I was looking for a red that would kind of mute out and be a little on the darker side, especially after I put the washes on it later. And I think this is the perfect red for this job. Remember, candy cane stripes are spirals, so you want to make sure and continue that pattern all the way around as you go. This miniature is difficult because the candy cane is right up against the miniature, but it has a neat effect when you get it done. Next, we're going to be changing out to Percone Paints base wood, and for this we'll be painting out all of the wooden arms and in the case of two of our miniatures, the club and the broom will be painted out with the base wood as well. Now I'm going to be doing some accenting with Percone Paints Stone Edge, which is very similar to like a bone color in the Vallejo line. I'll be painting the bristles of the broom in this, and then there are some detailed spots on some of the miniatures, such as the fur around the coat of one of the miniatures, which will get painted out in Stone Edge. We'll be right back. Now for the clothing on our miniatures, we're going to be using two different colors of gray. The first is called somber gray, which is the darker of the two. I'll be doing half of each of the clothing pieces on both miniatures in this color. For the rest of the clothes on these miniatures, we're going to be using cold gray, which is a little bit lighter but along the same sort of a tone. Now, if you don't have several different grays to choose from, of course you could start out with black and lighten it up with white, but I happen to have a paint set, so that makes it a little easier for me. Now most of the real accenting on these miniatures is going to come from washes. We'll start off first with null oil, and we're going to basically go over the entire piece with this to give it a very dirty look. Pay special attention to the mouths of some of these snowmen and make sure that you leave the wash extra dark there.
Thank you.
Next, we'll be using Drakenhof Nightshade, which is a dark blue wash, and mostly I'm using this at the joints in the balls of snow on the snowmen, just to give it a little shadow and a little depth. Next, I've got Agrax Earthshade going on all the wood parts. This is my go-to wash for weathering wood. A little bit of Athonian Camo Shade from Citadel will give all of our clothes that moldy kind of green mossy look, which is exactly what I'm going for with these zombie snowmen. Next, I'll hit all of the clothes with Seraphim Sepia, a nice brown tone which will round out that kind of muddy look that I'm going for. Now it's time for a little dry brushing. I'm going back to Stone Edge and I'm going to do some dry brushing over all of the pieces. I'm going to pay particular attention to put it on a little heavier where the snow is because I want to lighten that back up and make it look kind of white again. And our last paint detail will just be to take a little Karaberg Crimson for the teeth, just to give them that fresh blood look. Now it's time to turn our attention to the bases. For the snow effect on them, I'm just mixing up a little bit of AK Snow Micro Balloons with some just regular all-purpose Elmer's Glue All. You want to get this thick, but not so thick that it's basically dry, and then just use whatever tool you're comfortable with to apply it to the bases. This can look a little messy, and as it starts to set, we're going to take a sculpting tool and we're going to kind of press it into place and add some textured ridge lines to make it look a little bit more like snowdrifts. Make sure and keep the rim of your base clean. I like a nice black base when I paint up miniatures, and I think that allowing this to be messy and overhang will ruin the effect of this miniature on this base. And then we'll allow this to fully dry before we add any other little detail effects on top of the snow, or add a small light wash to finish it out. Maybe they were summoned by an evil wizard to do his bidding, or maybe Santa simply has gone deranged. But no matter how you look at it, you can't argue that these snowmen aren't awesome, and they'll be a great addition to any tabletop. I hope you guys have enjoyed this video, and as always, make sure to leave me any comments below if you have any questions. Hey, if you like these videos and want to help me keep making them, make sure you hit the like and subscribe button.